Hello everyone and welcome to Blitz Chess number 25. In this series of videos I play a Blitz game, I walk you through what I think, and your job as a viewer is to pause the video from time to time, maybe ask yourself what would I play in this position, and in that way we can all learn. Okay, we found a game, we're playing with the white pieces against Terror Boy, good luck. We're gonna play e4, knight f6, we're gonna play e5, this is the Alekhine defense unless black wants to go knight g8, which sounds like a joke, but in reality this is... It is kind of, okay, not serious, but it does have a point, which is white is overextended, and I'm going to undermine white center. But 95, of course, is a better version of that. I'm going to play d4. d6, I'm expecting. I'm going to play knight f3, supporting my center. Bishop g4 is possible, knight c6 is possible, my opponent goes for bishop g4. I'm going to unpin my knight, so I'm going to play bishop e2, which is a very natural developing move. I'm going to castle now. And Alekhine, the only thing you have to make sure is that you don't overextend yourself so much. Because you are in danger of just moving pawns forward endlessly and realizing later on, when it's too late, that you can't cover all the space you've occupied. Which is the definition of overextension. I'm going to play knight bd2, although c4, knight b6. Can I afford occupying space like that? You know, an idea came to mind. If I play a4, then if castles, I play c4, knight b6, a5. That seems to be pretty nice. I can always take on d6, by the way. And if bishop takes d6, I'm claiming that black had to spend 2 tempies with the bishop, which should be beneficial for me. And not only that, after e takes d6, bishop takes d6, c4, knight b6 is no longer possible because of c5. So e takes d6, c takes d6 has to be played by black, which I'm quite sure is not bad or anything. There's a transformation of the position. So I'm going to keep my pawn on e5. I don't see any reason to not do so. I also have the idea of knight c3, by the way. But black cannot take. Black can ignore it. So I have to increase my time management skills. That's why I'm going to play h3. Asking the question, if bishop takes f3, I'm happy I have the bishop here. I'm assuming bishop h5 has to be played. And I have a plan of knight d2, knight e4, knight g3, and maybe my knight is better located in g3. But my opponent kind of reminds me that did blunder a knight f4, which may have been not a blunder in terms of material, but I did lose the bishop here. And the stronger you are, the more the bishop here matters. So already there, I'm a little bit annoyed. Knight takes d4, I thought I had something. But now I'm realizing that queen b5 is never working because knight takes b5. So this is a mistake. Knight takes d4, I'm in trouble. My question now is there any way I can sacrifice the queen or something? Because believe it or not, I have to start thinking about desperate measures. Also, d takes e7, knight takes e2 is check, which is very important. If black wasn't getting the queen with check, then I would be getting the queen in exchange. So already here, I've made a mistake. Knight takes f3 is kind of the only way to make the most of the mistake, as far as I see. It's check, I have to damage my pawn structure. And after something like c takes d6, I'm putting all my money in queen b5 check, which picks up the bishop. And actually, that was pretty clever. I was lucky to find that. It is useful to be aware of tactics as a whole. So that's what I can say out of the positives. But yeah, queen d3, I'm attacking the knight. I'm threatening to take this bishop. And if bishop takes f3, which I wasn't very impressed by, I thought I could either take on e7. Actually, what's this? Ah, 92 check. Ah, but then I take, and I'm winning. I think I'm winning after this. 92 is nothing. Queen takes e2, bishop takes e2, e takes d8. I'm winning by material. I have an extra knight. Queen d5, I just take. Queen takes e7, I just take on d4. Yeah, my opponent thought they were winning. I thought they were winning. And turns out I'm winning now. What a funny world. Queen d5 looks active. Maybe it's the best try, but after g takes f3, I don't see anything for my opponent. Even more so because there's a pawn on e7 that allows black to... disables black's castling chances. Possibilities. Queen d7, g takes f3 as well. Queen takes c7, queen takes d4. Is there anything black can do? No. Bishop e2, I always take and promote to a queen. Take the queen and promote to a queen with check. Black has to do something about that in the meantime. I think my opponent missed knight e2. My opponent was always thinking king h2 or king h1. To which I think black is okay. I'm gonna take on d4 now. Attacking g7. If bishop takes e4, I'm happy to trade pieces and I'm a bishop up. Or a pawn, but yeah. Probably getting the pawn back, by the way, as well. I'm gonna take this. Queen takes b7 is also a threat, so if black has to spend a tempo... Oh my goodness. Queenside castling. Okay. I'm gonna play bishop e3. I'm gonna attack the freshly weakened pawn on a7. Most of the time, these pawns are... Well, actually, all the time, these pawns are defended because there's a rook on a8. But yeah, back to the game. This is a question of whether I can convert this or not, and hopefully I will be able to. So f5 is a weakening move, by the way, as well. Queen e5, my queen is sitting nice and steadily in the center. Black is in a desperate position, of course, so that's the reason why they do that. I'm going to play bishop c5. I think I have several ways of playing this position. I'm wondering which one's the most convincing. I think a4, a5 is an idea. b4, b5, b6 is an idea. But as many people... oh my goodness. Thank goodness that's not a blunder. So it is clearly a mouse slip. But because of this, queen takes h8. I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to take... That almost gave me a heart attack. Oof. Actually, it was a good move. By accident. Okay, back to the game. What do we do? Bishop e3. F4, bishop d4. And if c5, that's illegal. So bishop d4. I'm going to play rook e2 now. Not so scared of the counterplay. Because rather than counterplay, I think I'm going to play f3. I'm going to solidify everything very soon. So my rook is always defending g2, which is nice. And yeah, c4, c5 comes to my mind. Queen h5 is nothing to worry about. I take. There we go. We trade pieces. I play rook e2. And the more pieces you trade, the more likely you're going to win the game. So hopefully that was instructive from the converting point of view. Which is actually difficult. Don't underestimate conversion. Conversion is... As Korshnoi used to say, one of the most difficult things to do in a position in chess. I think it was Viktor Korshnoi. Before. Okay, my opponent resigns. Good game. Pretty much as a summarize or learns, things we learned is, it turns out that black is not winning after knight takes d4. I did make a mistake by allowing knight f4. Maybe it's not a mistake because I do have activity. I'm developed more than my opponent. But definitely I should have double checked before that because the bishop pair is the bishop pair. Knight takes e2, queen takes e2, knight c6. I should have seen that knight takes d4 was a real threat. I thought that I calculated well, but I didn't. Knight takes d4. Luckily, I have this queen d3 resource. My opponent didn't want to go knight takes f3, g takes f3, because I think I'm winning here as well. Funnily enough, I have a double threat of playing queen b5 and d takes c7. You can't stop both of them at the same time. So black went for bishop takes f3, but that also loses. I don't want to lie to you, the viewer, so I'm going to double check. I'm going to turn on the analysis. And let's see if this is losing for black. It is. And in fact, the only way to win as white is queen d3. Everything else is either equal or losing. Queen c4 is equal, because now bishop takes f3 is better. I can't take anymore because queen d5 is there. Interesting. So queen d3 is the absolute only way of winning. And after this, we had a... Kind of, you know, everything standard until I kind of almost blundered here. I'm lucky that rook takes d2, queen takes h8 is there. And yeah, I went for a good plan, actually. I wanted to double rooks. I was going to take... Oh, another mouse loop. I wanted to take and play rook e1, which is another way of playing. If rook d5, I just take. And I'm not losing the bishop because there's back rank. So that was my idea, but okay. Rook d2, thank goodness this is not a blunder. And then I won the game eventually, I think. Everything was pretty convincing. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, any suggestions, if you want me to do anything in another video, please let me know. If you have the time, I would really appreciate it if you like, subscribe, and you interacted with this video. I would really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.